My name is Daniel George. I'm a biologist with the National Park Service. I work with the Inventory Monitoring Program, and we primarily are focused now on studying a suite of key natural resources we call vital signs, and we have a team of ecologists and biologists that do long-term ecological monitoring. So I first heard about iNaturalist from a friend and had just briefly checked out the website, but I don't think I'd created any records until we started planning for the Golden Gate BioBlitz, and then I created some practice records just to, so I knew I would know what I was talking about when the BioBlitz came, and it quickly caught me up in it, and I must have created, you know, 50 or 100 records before the BioBlitz, and then I've just kept making some ever since then when we've gone for hikes or whatnot. Lately I've been working on getting my plant list to surpass my bird list, because I got nearly 300 birds on there, and I thought, you know, there's so many more plants in the world, I need to spend time discovering plants, and I just surpassed 300 plant species, so I was like, okay, good, I'm getting this a little more proportional to the actual diversity. I really like it as a memory tool. It helps me sort through what I saw, and by re-looking at my records and seeing what other people say things are, and kind of getting affirmation that I'm on the right track or needed a little help on one or the other, that's really helped me sort through and categorize things better, which I really enjoy. And then I really like the fact that I'm putting a record out there that other people can also use. And by being something that California Academy can have as part of their archive over time, it makes me feel like I'm contributing something beyond just having a handful of memories on my computer at home, which is what I had done in the past with all my digital photos. One thing I hope to look at over time is to have it be a tool that we can readily invite visitors to contribute their observations from the park to. And we've used these little paper cards for years and years, and sometimes it's difficult to understand exactly where the person was. And by having a smartphone photograph that's geotagged, and the person sends us a photo, you know, we can learn a lot more about what they saw and where it was. But also just, you know, using it as an education tool to have people explore and share information with one another and learn more about their park that way, even by seeing other people's observations and getting excited about them, something else they might discover the next time they're out. I'm helping a couple of different parks get oriented to the idea of using iNaturalist and think through the design of how they do set up their walks and the education material that they'll share with people. And then I'll be helping on the day of with the Pinnacles National Park BioBlitz. I think it's going to be really great to see the collective information from so many different parks coming together, and, you know, seeing the maps of all those different observations and the kinds of diversity across the span of the whole continent. I think it's going to be really fascinating. So the same way that I had that experience of, you know, creating images of flowers that I saw on hikes and putting them on my hard drive for my memories, if we can take those from, you know, thousands of people and aggregate them, we're going to be able to, I think over time, we're going to have some interesting things that we can see that any one person in isolation wouldn't be able to see. So I think the platform, by being able to let people from all over who don't know each other yet add information together is a really powerful tool. I tend to think of, like, the concept of BioBlitz, you know, we focus a lot on, you know, the blitz end of it, but I like to think of it as just day one in a longer process. So I like to think of them as compressed expeditions, and for, you know, people to just think of themselves as an explorer in their own backyard or in their local park or wherever they're interested in, and go out and learn. And instead of, you know, 100 years ago where we might have shot an animal or put it in a jar of alcohol, you know, they can take a snapshot or hopefully, you know, a well thought out photo with key features to share with someone else. And they get a chance, we all get a chance, to have that moment of being a contemporary Alfred Russel Wallace or Charles Darwin, and we saw something of great interest, or maybe it's growing in a different spot than we expected, or it's a behavior we hadn't seen before. And if we can record that and share with others, I think it has really great value.